Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. So this question belongs to GATE CSE 2014, set to question 14, guys. Okay, yes. So let us go through the question. So consider the tree arc of a BFS traversal from the source node. W is an unweighted, okay, so it is an unweighted graph, connected and undirected graph. Okay, so the tree T formed by the tree arc is data structure for computing. Okay, so the question is really a bit confusing, right? So at some points he is saying it is a graph, at some points he is calling it as a tree. So the first assumption which you should take is, so let us first of all take a graph, guys. Okay. Okay, so this is a simple graph, right? Yes. So now I took this graph. Okay. So now what he is saying, he is trying to consider a tree arc, right? Yes. So tree arc means, so how BFS will work, guys? Okay. So how BFS will work? It will be doing like breadth by breadth, right? So layer by layer indirectly it will work. So if you are working in that way, what will be the thing which you can calculate? Okay, so it is saying the first option is the shortest path between every pair of vertex. So is it possible, guys? Technically it is not possible. Okay, so anyway, let us continue. The shortest path from W to every vertex in the graph. Okay, similarly the shortest path from W to only those nodes whose are leaves. Okay, so the longest path to the graph. Okay, so now let us start. So assume that you started here. Okay, so you went through the first layer. Okay, so once you reach the first layer, what will you understand, guys? So you will understand that the distance between this node and this node is 1. Similarly, the distance between this node and this node is 1. Okay, so once you go through the next layer, that is nothing but next arc. So you will say that the distance between this node and this node is 1, right? So this node to this node, what will be the distance, guys? It is nothing but this node distance plus 1. So this distance will be 2. Similarly, here also 2. So if you go for one more layer, okay, so the arc 3. So at this time, the distance between this to this will be this distance, that is nothing but 1 plus the previous distance 2. Similarly, 1 plus the previous distance 2. So in this way, you can calculate the distances from root node for each and every node, right? Okay, yes. So now you can easily identify the option. So it finds the shortest distance between every pair. No, is it? It's only finding from root vertex to each and every vertex. Okay. So the second option, the shortest path from W to every vertex. Yes, this sounds really good. The third option, the shortest path from W to only those leaves. No, it is finding for the between nodes also, 1, 2, in that way. Okay. Similarly, option D, the longest path. No. So now you got an idea, right? So how I am saying the arc layers are just counting the distance between that node to that node. Got it? Yes. So now I hope everyone got a clear idea on this question. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Okay? Yes. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.